Today I want to hit on something really important to me in recovery because I have a tendency to forget this, and that is that recovery is different for everybody. You know, we're taught in AA to focus on our similarities and not our differences. And sometimes that can lead us to actually compare ourselves to other people, and we need to not do that. We need to realize that in recovery, in our disease and what brought us here, let's focus on the similarities. But in recovery, we've got to remember it's different for everybody. And so a lot of us can get caught up in a trap of comparing ourselves to the next person. You know, we might be in recovery with someone who just seems to be happy all the time, totally has their stuff together, and we don't feel like we're like that. And we start comparing ourselves, and it gets real frustrating. And that doesn't help us with recovery. We need to remember that recovery is different and value our own journey, our own personal journey. Think about that, value it, and not compare ourselves to other people. So there's one big reason why recovery can be different for everybody, and that's covered in Staying Sober by Gorski and Miller, which we've been looking at the past few videos. And this is described by patterns of post-acute withdrawal. So in yesterday's video, I talked about post-acute withdrawal syndrome, where people have symptoms like being unable to manage stress or having a hard time sleeping or even having physical coordination problems related to the period of time after they've had acute withdrawal from alcohol. So 7 to 14 days is when we go through acute withdrawal from alcohol or drugs, and then time after that, it could be several weeks, could be several months, could be a couple of years, where we might experience these post-acute withdrawal symptoms. And even post-acute withdrawal itself can have different patterns for people. So in the book, Gorski and Miller talk about different types of post-acute withdrawal. You could have regenerative withdrawal, where the post-acute withdrawal syndrome gets better over time. You could have degenerative, where it gets worse. You could have stable, where the symptoms just kind of stay the same all the time, don't seem to improve, don't seem to get worse. And then you could have intermittent, where it comes and goes and comes and goes. And so I seem to experience the intermittent pause the most. I will go through periods of time where I don't experience that many symptoms of pause, but then all of a sudden they come back and I find myself struggling with what should be simple tasks or struggling with tasks I didn't struggle with the day before. That's a big sign to me that something's not quite ticking right in my head. And that's okay. That's a result of intermittent pause. That's a result of what I go through as part of my journey in recovery. One of the things that we need to realize is that, you know, our ultimate, and they talk about it in the book, they say, then the goal is to reduce how often they, or these symptoms, occur, how long the episode lasts, and how bad the symptoms are. You must remember that even when you are not experiencing them, there is always the tendency for them to recur. And that's one of the things that I think sticks in my head as super important in recovery, is that relapse to me is kind of like the force of gravity. And we alcoholics and drug addicts left untouched tend toward relapse. So if I'm not working any program, if I'm not doing any of the things that I've learned how to do in my program, then I am tending toward relapse. More than likely, eventually, without any program, without any spiritual work, without any kind of recovery work, I will relapse. More than likely. It's not 100%. Now, I know that, and personally I can feel it in every bone in my body, that without doing this work, I'm going to be back hitting the bottle or hitting the joint at some point. It's going to happen. And so I know I have to do this work every day. I got to hit it every single day. I make sure to hit, to make this video every day, because I've got to get this work in or else I'm going to end up back there. Now, that doesn't mean that, you know, it is certain. It just means that it becomes more and more probable. And so, you know, I know that some people feel so good that relapse seems like a very improbable thing to them. And as long as those people are doing the work, that's where we want to be. It's when you're feeling good and you feel like you're not going to relapse and you're also not doing the work, that's when you're starting to slide back into your old habits. So we want to get to that place where we're doing the work, we are fighting against these tendencies back toward relapse, fighting against the pause symptoms that we have, doing the things we need to do to build ourselves up in recovery in order to counteract the symptoms that are going to come up. And so that's really what I've taken from this, is that, you know, most, first and foremost, I can't compare myself to other people in recovery. It's no good. I can be inspired by other people in recovery. That's great. You know, it's one thing to be inspired by other people and to say, hey, that guy's got something I want. I'm gonna do the kind of things he's doing, you know. That's important. But looking at someone and then getting down on yourself because you're not like them, we got to steer clear of that. And this passage explains why even the different types of pause that people experience contribute to their overall different experience on the recovery journey. So value your journey. Value what you are putting into the journey, and put what you need to into that journey so that you are not walking back toward relapse. You know, as long as you're putting in the work, then you're going away from relapse. And that's where you kind of get to that point where you feel very confident that that's not on the horizon for you. And that, in my experience, that confidence just continues to grow as I keep putting in the work. The more I put in, the better I feel. Just got to keep putting it in. So that's what I wanted to go over today. Tomorrow, we talk a little bit more about managing pause. And there's a lot of good information about managing pause, which is super important, because the more you learn about this, the more you see the frustration you can feel, the frustration you can have from dealing with pause could be enough to drive someone right back to drinking and drugging. And it's understandable, because the symptoms can be pretty severe for some folks. So we'll talk some more tomorrow about how to manage those symptoms. In the meantime,